So I decided that I was going to start working on the instruments for my flight simulator. Hopefully I can use the six main instruments that I wanted to use. I collected these instruments over the years and I figured it will add to the realism of the flight simulator if I can convert these into something that I can use in the simulator. I could print 3D print most of them, but I figured it will add more realism if I can actually convert them, and the main component for that would be this little motor, which is a servo motor. It's very cheap. You can buy it anywhere in Amazon. Basically, the electronics that control this motor connect to the flight simulator, and then the values are extracted from the flight simulator, like altitude, angle of bank, and other like speed and whatever, and then it gets transmitted into the motor, and then this little axle moves, and that then can be used to translate into motion into these instruments. So I have six main instruments that I'm working on: the altitude indicator, the vertical speed indicator, the attitude indicator, the speed indicator, and the turn coordinator. So those are the instruments that I'm working on. Actually, that's five instruments. Yeah, five instruments. And yeah, maybe I can use more of these that I have here. I have made one in the past using those motors. You can see here, I attached this to an attitude indicator that I got. And basically, this engine or this little motor moves the ball this way, and then this engine moves it this way. And so, when you connect it with the electronics and combine those two, that's basically what provides the motion, and it's accurate with the flight simulator. So what I like about these instruments is the mechanics that are inside, and I want to preserve as much as I can and just use what they have, and then attach the motors, because the motion is really not doesn't require a lot of force. So this, for example, would need two motors, one for the this motion, and then the other one for this motion. So yeah, it's pretty neat to see these instruments from the inside, and then figure out a way to convert them into usable for the flight simulator. The speed indicator is also very, very interesting. I just looking at the different parts here, you can figure out where the motion actually happens for the needle to move, and then if I can figure out a way to attach the motor to it, then it should be doable. The turn coordinator was an interesting instrument. Had a lot of parts in it. I took most, these are just for that. I took that out, and basically just have to attach this motor basically here, and then that will move that plane back and forth, and I get the values from the flight simulator. And then obviously the second motor will move this ball for the turn. Same for the vertical speed indicator, which is just basically I have to attach. I just want to use the mechanism that is in there already. Oops. Yeah, so I just want to use that mechanism that's already in there to so that it can be used with the flight simulator. The altitude indicator has been a challenge to take apart. There's a lot of parts that go into this instrument. I took most of it out, but I was able to basically bring it down to this axle that moves the needles. You see, there is a short needle for the 10,000, and there's the thicker one for the 1,000, and the thin long one for the hundreds of heats. So the good thing is, by just moving this, I can basically use all three of them in one shot. I just have to figure out how to translate those values from the flight simulator into the motor.